Marston. Mr. Marston, don't be so childish. Come on, sir, I implore you. So I made a few innocent mistakes for the last event. But my plan is still sound. Together we can conquer, if not the world, and certainly Bill Williamson.
But first, you need me to do you a favor?
Oh, you read my mind. I can only produce. You've been taking my tonic, sir, as instructed. It can give the most ordinary of intelligences a remarkable insight.
I'll give you insight. I'll show you what your guts look like.
Please, sir, this show of petulance is nothing short of embarrassing. Think for a moment, sir. Think.
I'm thinking about how much of my time you're wasting.
Sir, I am about to do something which I greatly discourage in all wise and rational men. A selfless act for you. But, sir, before I act selflessly, allow me to act selfishly and sell some of my wares.
Fair enough.
Oh, good, sir. Come, and let's go visit some of our fine friends in the other oil business we have here in Plainview. These men need all the help they can get.
Ladies and gentlemen, gather round. My friends, are you ready to change your lives forever? I have something truly extraordinary to show you today. A medical breakthrough from the East, the result of years of scientific research.
There's no need for that, sir. I ask only that you try my tonic.
Hardworking souls of Plainview, do you suffer from rheumatism, lumbago, acute chronic sciatic, neurologic or inflammatory pain? Well, I represent the only company that makes the genuine article which cures headache, neuralgia, toothache, earache, backache.
This man is a fucking charlatan. He just got done swindling us down at Cho Springs with this song and dance.
I say we tar and feather him right now.
I say we shoot the bastard.
I think it's time we take a business elsewhere. I apologize if science is not your forte. Good day, one and all.
Somebody get that thing back.
St. Homobonus has not been looking down on me favorably.
Who?
Homobonus, the patron saint of businessmen.
I'd say he's giving you your just desserts.
No, poppycock. Those ingrates were clearly informed of my refund policy.
You can only shit on people for so long before they decide it's their turn to pull down the pan.
A crude metaphor in every sense of the word, my dear boy. You leave the business to me. Do I try to tell you how to rob banks?
Robbing banks felt more honest than this.
Yes! You got him!
For who? like the global expansion of your West Dickens elixir might have come a cropper.
Nonsense. Just another bump on the science's rocky road. One less moron to worry about. I bet Louis Pasteur didn't have to deal with this shit. Ignorant hillbillies. Oh my good God! They blocked the road! Against the weight of plebeian ignorance, my boy. Keep that gun at the ready, my dear boy.
Maybe you need to think about a change of career.
I will never give up on science. How can these people harbor such bitterness?
Well, I ain't surprised. That tonic I drank at Ridgewood went through me like a dose of salt.
That's it!
Stop shooting at me!
John, there's Quavaseca up ahead. Well, that was a little hairy. Thank you, my dear boy. You saved the day again.
Me with the speed with which a group of men can turn from passive sheep into murderous wolves.
I'm impressed with how you nearly got us killed back there.
Yes, perhaps we should shelve the tonics business for a period.
Let's say we try our hand at racing again. There's a meet at Ratskeller.
You're trying my patience, Mr. West Dickens.
Well, I'm sorry, dear boy, but I'm only an aging vendor of exotic elixirs, not the bloody U.S. Cavalry. Forgive me if matters take some time to prepare.
Mr. West Dickens.
Ah, Mr. Marston. How wonderful to see you, sir. How wonderful.
Are we ready, then?
Yes, sir. Nearly, sir. Very nearly, sir. I just need some cash to get some extra hardware fitted to my old Trojan horse here.
You what?
Never mind, sir. I can only presume that you have not enjoyed the benefits of a classical education, so I will not take umbrage if some of my illusions sail over your head, sir.
I won't pretend to understand you, but I will endeavor to make you understand me. Either we do this right now, or I put a bullet in you and get on with my day.
Please, I knew you were a violent man, Mr. Marston, but I did not think you were a stupid one. We need money to outfit my carriage, to turn a simple tradesman's vehicle into something more subterfuge. And I'm about to tell you how we are going to gain said cash. Now I know that you ride very well. So come, sir, to Rathskeller Fork!
Follow me, John! It's not too far to Rathskeller Fork!
Come!
So how are you, John?
Okay, all things considered. Hopefully we can get through today without running into another army of your satisfied customers.
Onwards and upwards! I refuse to let the blind stupidity of the proletariat derail my calling in life.
Nothing blind about it. I'd say they saw
you
right through
you. You love that trigger, don't you? Before knowledge comes doubt, my dear boy.
Everybody knows you're as crooked as a dog's hind leg, West Dickens.
I resent that implication, John.
I wasn't implying. I was telling. If you're such a successful businessman, what are you doing living in a cave?
Delightfully Dickensian, isn't it?
If you say so.
Are you familiar with the concept of philanthropy, John?
I'm surprised you are.
Oh, I don't do any of this for myself, John. I hope you realize that.
You're crazy, old man.
It's been quite a ride, John, hasn't it?
We haven't gone that far.
No, I mean us. Ridgewood Farm, Gaptooth Reach, Plainview. We make quite a team, you and me. Brains and brawn. We should consider a more permanent partnership.
This partnership ends as soon as I have Bill Williamson. I appreciate your help, but I've just about had it with all your schemes. You need to realize what's at stake here.
I know, John, I know. Just win this race and we'll be ready. I give you my word. There it is, John. Rathskeller Port.
Gentlemen, this will be a fair race. No shooting, stabbing, cliff pushing, rock throwing, cactus grinding, neck lassoing, setting fires, or other acts that causes the rider to unfairly lose his way, or bleed heavily, or black out. Get yourselves ready. Set.
Yeah.
gentlemen, this will be a fair race.
conquered. What a fantastic spectacle, John. Let's take a moment to bask in the glory of our victory.
Have we got enough money now?
All right. Yes, once Seth and Irish have furnished their side of the bargain, I think we should be ready. Quite a team we've assembled, don't you think?
A bunco, a grave robber, and a drunk. How could things possibly go wrong?